Genèse chapitre 9.
Genesis chapter 9.
Tokotanga wana na verset 27 kino na 26.
We'll read from verses 20 to 26.
Tozana simatango tokumela mibite.
We're behind time.
Genèse chapitre 9.
Genesis chapter 9, verses 20 to 26. And when we've got it, can we stand up in Jesus' name? Amen. I'll read in Jesus' name. After the flood, Noah became a farmer and planted a vineyard. One day he became drunk on some wine he had made and lay naked in his tent. Ham, the father of Canaan, saw that his father was naked and went outside and told his brothers. Shem and Japheth took a robe and held it over their shoulders, walked backward into the tent and covered their father's naked body. As they did this, they looked the other way so they wouldn't see him naked. When Noah woke up from his drunken stupor, he learned what Ham and his younger son had done. Then he cursed the descendants of Canaan, the son of Ham. Cursed on the Canaanites. May they be the lowest of servants to the descendants of Shem and Japheth. Then Noah said, may Shem be blessed by the Lord my God, and may Canaan be his servant. Amen.
Amen. Noé fut le premier cultivateur à planter de la vigne. Il but du vin, s'enivra et se déshabilla complètement à l'intérieur de sa tente. Cham, père de Canaan, vit son père tout nu et en avertit ses deux frères qui étaient dehors. Alors Sem et Japheth prirent un manteau, le placèrent sur leurs épaules, entrèrent à reculons dans la tente et recouvrirent leur père. Ils regardaient dans la direction opposée pour ne pas voir leur père tout nu. Quand Noé fut sorti de son ivresse, il apprit ce que lui avait fait son plus jeune fils. Alors il déclara, « Maudit soit Canaan, qu'il soit pour ses frères le dernier des esclaves. » Puis il ajouta, « Béni soit le Seigneur, le Dieu des Saints, que Canaan soit l'esclave des Saints. » Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Père de la gloire, nous te disons merci. Parce que le temps en vole de l'amitié, mon ami. Nous ne sommes rien si ce n'est que de la poussière. Mais Dieu n'a télémi, kakanangoluna yo, on a posapo la bonzambe na yo. Yamwana mon konzi, mon kota monanga, mon kota yokanan, ayokangai. Bakota la bamona yesu katinanga, bako yoka ba yoka mongomona yesu na sena mongomonanga. Pen zambe. Mokona moko, asala lokola mabele kitoko, oyo mbuma ekwei, yonde noksamvula de kolona mo, potewe kubi makat nesiga oyo, ezala ni pamboli katikati na biso, Dieu de la gloire, fongola matoye na biso, na mitema na biso, ezala preya ko recevoir, to recevoir katina bosomi, katina li memia nyoso, poteli lorano, nezali kisi, oyo kome mano biko, na bomo na biso. Dieu de la gloire, to yambi amona di menya, kote li lorano, neko sala toza la balongi, li lorano, neko sala toza la, batu katina elonga, ba champion, na pomo na Yesu. Amen.
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 Mate alelo tolobi, natina ya maturité chrétienne.
Today's preaching is about the Christian maturity.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Mwana soba botami.
A child when they are born.
Somebody need to be in the camera, please. Mwana soba botami.
A child when they are born.
Azala kamoke.
They are little.
Azala ka bebe.
They are baby.
Beta waza bebe.
And when they are baby.
Asala kamatambo nyoso lokola bebe.
They do everything as a baby.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Me kokoma na tango.
But it will come to
mwana oyo azala ki bebe.
The child that was a baby.
Bokomi kokama ye.
You start to surprise you. You were surprised. Was this the same person that is now a big man, is now a big woman?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because somebody has grown up.
Amen.
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 Amen. When we started this work, some of the children were truly babies.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But today we can see how they're growing up. We are seeing every step of the evolution of their life. But what we are seeing is the growth in body.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Somebody will grow in body.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's why the body needs to eat. That's why the body needs to be fed all the time. And when the body is strong, it will know how to grow. And when somebody is growing,
hallelujah.
Amen. But in spirit is also the same. We not only grow in body, but we also grow in spirit. The Bible tells us about Noah. A father back in the
day,
he was called by the name of Noah. The Bible says he was the first person to make a fire,
hallelujah.
Amen. Noah is the first person on this earth. From the beginning, the first person to do of the vineyard, it was Noah. And Noah, during
some time,
he beat his
wife
and he turned it into alcohol.
Hallelujah.
And he drank that wine. The Bible says, after drinking that wine, the wine was good in his mouth, in his stomach. That wine
was good.
And he bought a new wine. But after that wine, the wine went into his head. The wine went into his brain. And it made him
grow.
Because he saw that he was good, and he needed to put it in his life. But that wine brought him joy for only a short time.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's why after drinking the wine, the Bible says he got drunk.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The
Bible says he got drunk. And when he was drunk, after being drunk, he took off all his clothes. He took off all his clothes. And he was left naked. And he fell on the ground in the house in his nakedness.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And Noah, he had three male sons.
Hallelujah.
He had three sons.
Boye, bangomi sato.
And those three sons, one out of them,
actually was at
the middle.
Hallelujah.
Amen. It means a second son. Who was called Sham. He saw his father naked.
Amen.
Amen. He saw his father naked in the house. And he was naked.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He saw that his father was naked. For him, it was like something not to be surprised. It was not something that hurt him. He felt that it was something of joy.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And he went to call his older brother and his younger brother.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want you to understand. Not only did he want to call his brother, one was older than him, and the other was younger than him. And he went to call him. And he said, come see your father. He's naked.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Come and see our father. He's naked. The Bible says, his elder brother and his younger brother, his two brothers, they took a robe and they went to cover their father. The Bible says they went backward.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The Bible doesn't say anywhere that how when he saw his father that he started laughing at him or started to talk about him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But the Bible says when he saw his father, he went to go and tell his brothers. His brothers.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But in his brothers, one was older and one was younger. I'm telling you about this so you can understand. And when they received that message, their hearts were not happy. Because they understood something that their brother did not see. That's why the Bible says they took a robe and they went backwards.
Hallelujah.
Amen. They went backwards because they did not want to see their father naked. They wanted to make a difference between them and their brother's hand. And they went and they covered their father.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The father, the next morning, he woke up. The drunkenness is gone. He found himself, he remembered that he had clothes. But now he found himself covered in a robe. For him, he remembered that he went to bed with clothes. But he woke up with a robe. How did this robe come onto my body? Where is my clothes? And he wanted to know. Then he found out that his children, the first one and the last one, they came and they covered him with a robe. Because they found him naked under being drunk. And that message, they received it from their brother Ham.
Hallelujah.
Amen. When the father heard this news, it hurt him. His heart was hurt. And the father stood up and started to curse his son.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The father cursed his son. And for those that covered him, he blessed them.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you read the Bible, the Bible does not say that Noah cursed Ham. The Bible says he cursed his descendants. He cursed Canaan. It means that he cursed his grandchildren.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I want you to understand something.
We
have three children. But they are separated into two parts. The third part, that is had by
his
father. He saw his father naked.
Hallelujah.
Amen. For us, we say, a child that is mature, or a mature son, He is the friend of the Father. It means that he knows the bad things about the Father. And he keeps the secrets of the Father. And when the Father loses his way, he brings his Father back into the right way.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I will go back into it. In our tradition, we
have
a mature son. He is the friend of the Father. It means that he knows the things of the Father, the good and the bad. But he keeps the secret of the Father. And he tries to bring the Father back into the right way when he goes wrong.
Hallelujah.
Amen. These children, they were not children
either.
They were grown-ups.
Amen.
Amen. When God was killing the earth, he told Noah to build an ark. And Noah told the world, let's come together and build this ark. But nobody agreed with him. They saw him crazy. He told them, let's build an ark because rain is coming.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And Noah started to build the ark. They had to see him as crazy because you don't build an ark on land.
Amen.
Amen. A boat or an ark is built in the water.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Open your ears. But he is building an ark in the land.
Hallelujah.
Amen. People saw him and they thought this man must be crazy. And secondly, he's building an ark because he's telling people that rain is coming. He himself does not know what rain is. Noah himself did not know what rain is. Only God told him, build an ark because the rain is coming. But he himself, he doesn't know what rain is. Because from the time of Adam and Eve until the time of Noah, they never had rain.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Rain had never rained. But he is telling people, come, let us build an ark because rain is coming. They said that he's truly crazy because he's telling people about something that has never happened. But what people did not know, Noah spoke to God. And Noah heard the voice of God. Noah understood and he received the revelation from God. And Noah did not want to argue with God. Because he knew nobody on this earth can argue with God regarding anything. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Nobody on this earth can argue with God. For you, it's time for you that enters into silly
events
where there is no God. God doesn't work.
Hallelujah.
Amen. They are preaching to you. If you don't believe, don't believe. But don't go into the discussions.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The
Bible is alive.
Oh,
these people do not exist. Jesus did not even die.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Especially
on this earth where there are made so many films of Jesus. Don't disargue with God.
Amen.
Amen.
No one knew
this secret.
He knew
that God has spoken
to him.
He heard and he obeyed and he done it.
Amen.
Amen. When God speaks to you, listen, obey, and do it. Don't start to debate.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I
heard somebody say
something.
If you understood that God is the one that is speaking to you, don't argue.
Amen.
Amen. Noah heard God. That's why he obeyed. Abraham heard God. That's why he took his child to go and sacrifice.
Amen.
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 Amen. They started to build the ark. People came to look and they laughed. And they started to
look.
And they said, look at this man.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
I had the opportunity to visit a place where they build a boat.
Amen.
Amen.
Where
they build boats, even if it's in land, they will make a hole and bring water inside.
Amen.
Amen.
Même si on est dans la boue, par contre,
even if it's a land, they will create like a lake and they will build it onto the lake. Even us back home, when they build a boat, they will take it and they will build it near the sea.
Amen.
Amen.
Donc, les morts vont se faire en haut et vont venir les vont se tester en haut ce que vous indiquez,
The more they build it, they will sit it onto the sea to see whether it's going to drown or whether it's not going to drown.
Et quand Noah tombe dans la soie,
and when Noah built his ark, and it
fits,
and God told him to take all the animals, and they all entered inside.
Noah
entered him, him and his wife, and his three sons. These three sons that we are reading, and their wives.
Amen.
Amen. Only eight people entered into the boat. All the other people left
gossiping
at them, they said they are jealous because we are enjoying, because we are getting married, because we are having parties,
because
we are enjoying the disco. It's always that way. When you come to church, they laugh at you.
Amen.
Amen. Look at the brother. He's going to church. He's skipped. Look at the brother, he's praying.
He
can't handle the movement. Every time there's always people like that. They will laugh at you.
Amen.
Amen.
And the worst is always a pastor.
Especially when you're a pastor.
Amen.
Amen. It's sad because many pastors like to walk around with their bag under their shoulders. Especially the pastors in Europe.
So
you'll find them walking around so because the pastor, they think about their church all the time, their walk has changed.
Amen.
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 The walk has changed. And if you go past where there's young people, they'll say, look at him. Look at him. What does he look like? He's just following the tides.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. They laughed at Noah. They laughed at Noah. They were
Noah knew who was going to enter into the ark. Alléluia.
Amen.
He
spent 120 years.
Vous comprenez? 120 ans de tomber dans la
120 years building the ark.
120 ans à son tomber dans la
120 years building an ark.
Donc chaque jour, il y a la bataille.
Every day they will come and they will
come. Azara, on a des boucles à bataille.
They come
and
he is gone and they still see him there.
I'm not telling you a joke.
It's not a joke. He spent 120 years.
And that 120
years of being ghosted at.
Amen.
There's only one day it was a change. They laughed at him
for 120 years.
But one day
and
the day that he entered into the ark.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
People
did not understand. They were gossiping about him. I preached about this before. I will not go back
to it.
How God got the animals to enter into the ark. People sat in their countries and they found three lions walking by entering into the ark. I want you to have this image because the animals Noah did not go around chasing after each one of them.
Amen.
Amen. Like the zebras, they're only in Congo. They're not in the Congo. You can't find them anywhere else.
No one
could have not gone all over the world to go find them. But because
of the
and the work of God, all the animals, wherever they were, they heard the voice of God and they stood up. And the lion got his.
Amen.
The people lied and they hold on to him and said, let's go.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Going by, going into the ark.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want you to have this image and to understand. Because that
village
was animals go past them and go Some animals, beautiful animals like the tigers.
Tigre passe à Yakadonke.
They heard a lion in
their
village, but
he didn't say anything to them. Hallelujah.
Amen. The animals came and they entered. And Noah himself had entered. Because God is good. He closed the door himself.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And they were all looking and they were laughing. And they said, oh, it's finished. There's no water. How is he going to go? He entered with the animal. Is he going to start eating them one by one?
Amen.
And then all of a sudden they saw that it started to rain. They said, oh, maybe it will just rain until the evening. And the evening is still raining. The next day it's still raining, it's reading, it's going up. And they said, that joker, Noah, nothing
happened.
And they saw the water was still there. And they saw that the water was running. rising.
Ah.
And all that guy
is
going to finish. 4 days and it's still raining, and the final rain is going out, and it started entering into the houses. These things are all planned.
It's
like a joke, but it's becoming serious. That the plate is going by through the water.
Amen.
Amen. And they couldn't sleep in their bed anymore because the water is taking away their bed. And they started knocking on the door. And they said, Noah, Noah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I'm not preaching that preaching. I'm just giving you the image. Noah entered only with his three sons and their wives. And now they've come out.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The event
as it's happening, they already came out of the ark. God has already spread the word. All those people that laughed at them, they've all gone.
Amen.
Amen. And Noah here made his vineyard. And he drank the wine. And he got drunk. And he fell asleep. Naked.
Amen.
Amen.
Shama moni papa na ye.
Ham saw his father.
Man, bagne kona ye. Japhet na Shem.
But his brothers Shem and Japhet.
Basosola ke no moto kodi koma na bolumi ya papa.
They understood one thing. They said, we cannot see our father naked.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oko to kodi koma na bolumi ya papa na bisu.
We cannot see our father naked.
Mana abenga mite amu na bolumi ya papa.
A child is not called to see their parent naked.
Amen.
Amen. That's why they understood that thing. And they went backwards. They came to help their father. But they came with the intention that they have to be careful that they don't see their father naked.
Amen.
Amen. They did not know what would happen after seeing their father naked. But they knew a bad situation could happen. That's why the elder and the younger one, they came and they covered their father. But the middle one, but their middle brother, I've said it. The older brother. The older brother. Our child, when they mature, they are the friend of their father. Not if they had not only grown in body. It means that if they had grown spiritually, they would have known that this situation
is
good. The way I've seen it is not a good thing. I need to know how to protect my father.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I need to protect my father. Even though he did not, even though it's his fault, but at this moment that I have reached, I need to know how to compliment him in the place that he has. Because I'm your son that is already grown up.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's why we're talking about Christian maturity. Many of us are in the church for many, many years. But we are only separated into two parts. The group that sees the father's nakedness and the group that does not even want to see the father naked and is covering the father.
Amen.
Amen. Was mature in body.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He was a grown up in body.
Amen.
Amen. But his thinking thinking was not with him.
He
lacked
maturity.
His brain had not grown. He did not have a good experience in life. That's why he did not understand that this was my parent. That could not see him naked.
Amen.
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 Amen. It was not his fault to see his father naked.
Amen.
Amen. He did not ask to see his father naked. He did not look to go and see his father naked.
Accidentally.
But he entered into the home when he saw his father naked. But his attitude afterwards, what was it?
Hallelujah.
Amen. And you found your husband in a bad position. What is your attitude afterwards?
Amen.
Amen. What is your attitude afterwards?
Hallelujah.
Amen. All kinds of situations will
meet.
We don't go looking for it, but it happens to you. I've told you this testimony. I was going through the high road and I was going through the bus. I saw many children coming from school. And I saw Precious, they put him on the wall.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's when I was saying, oh,
and I
said
to myself, these boys, what are they doing to Precious? Because I saw that they put Precious on the wall. And I got off the bus. And I went back to see where he was. Precious and his friends already left that place. They were in a group of boys and girls and they were walking.
Some of the boys, as you girl,
And one of the boys held onto the girl.
When I was in a secondary school.
This is when they were in secondary school. I already saw them from far. And I got off the bus and I started to follow them. And they were walking.
Amen.
And they were walking.
Amen.
And Precious was also in that group. And then some of his friends, they saw me. I did not know what they were talking about.
Precious, your dad is coming.
But I heard somebody say, Precious, your dad is coming.
Amen.
Amen. Precious did not turn around. They thought they saw me first, but I already saw them from the bus. I thought maybe they were being bullied by some naughty boy. And as I was walking towards Precious, the way Precious had to run away. Precious had run, turned around, run away. He didn't look.
I said, oh, Precious, your dad is coming back.
They said to him, only your dad is coming. Precious did not look. He ran away so fast.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He ran and he turned around in
different
direction. He ran away and he turned around and he came back from the back as if he was coming on his own. And when I came, I told his friends, don't worry, just tell him that I saw him. As I got near the home, I saw precious coming and walking out so slowly. And he's walking as if that dad did not see
him.
I didn't say anything to him, but I left a message to his friend.
Amen.
You will meet with problems that you did not
But
your reaction, how will your reaction be?
Amen.
In the church, we are all good people. But when you go home, and a mistake could happen with your child, how will your reaction be?
Amen.
When you go home, something will happen with your
child.
How would your reaction be?
Amen.
That's why many fathers are being kicked out of the house with black babies.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We all come to situations in marriage, family, a bad situation, and it can disturb your
family.
But your reaction, if your reaction is bad, then you all could be suffering.
Amen.
Amen. Ham, when he saw his father, the child that is with God, he will know that this is my father. I've seen him by accident, but let me protect him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. A clever child, maybe that conversation his other brothers would have not
He
could have gotten his father, taken him and covered him and put him into the room, and that would have been it.
Amen.
How would your reaction be when you come home and you find your husband is drunk?
Yesterday my husband, as I like naked, I like naked.
Would you stand up and you go and tell your neighbors that yesterday my husband was naked and he was sleeping on the floor?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's why you find unclever fathers talking about their wives outside.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. How would your reaction be when you see your father being caught in a shop that he was stealing? Yes, but he is How would your reaction be?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Because the relationship between the father and the
son,
whether you're grown up or not, whether you're married, you will always be a child. Even if you're a big boss, you will still be a child. Even if you're not so big, you will still be a child.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I
feel sorry that I destroyed my name in the deed of the house.
Amen.
Amen. In body, it was just something not normal that I did. I was angry and I erased my name. But spiritually, it was something big that I was doing.
Amen.
Amen.
It's serious.
It's serious what I did. I took my name and I erased it in the deed. Physically, it was nothing, but spiritually, something big that I had done. I gave myself into the hands of the enemy.
Amen.
Amen. And there are many husbands who are that way, especially when you don't have a maturity. You argue a little bit and then you leave your bedroom and go to the living room. It's something serious in the eyes of God. Amen. Whatever happens, whether you argue or not, remain in the bedroom. chasing backwards, but at least stay in the bedroom. Don't make that mistake.
Spiritually, it's a grave.
Spiritually, it's something great. You're declaring divorce. And you're declaring separation from God.
Amen.
Amen. Many women, when they argue, they say, "Oh, you think I want this? And in this marriage, I'm suffering anyway."
Amen.
Amen. Many times it's the women that do this.
William Sapke.
Many women, when they
have
an issue, you think you're the only man. This marriage is
terrible.
And they'll take their ring and they'll throw it at the husband.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's serious.
It's a big deal.
Amen.
Amen.
It's
the same way. What Ham had done. He found his father naked. A child that has matured in the things of God. A child that is mature in the family. They will take the father and they will find the father. And they will not even tell the story to their brothers. They will not even want their brothers to know this thing.
Amen.
Amen. The child that is mature, they need to be able to protect their father. Because it's the dignity of the entire family.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But he went and he told his brothers the story. One was younger than him in age. They went backward.
Hallelujah.
Amen. It means that they say that we could not see our father naked. We cannot see our father naked. Because they knew nakedness. It's a sign of sin.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because the first people that were naked were Adam and Eve. Every year that they were naked, they did not know. They did not know. But the day that sin had entered into them, they knew that they were naked.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Nakedness is a sign of sin. Adam and Eve, they could not be cursed. Because they were a couple, they were married.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But because sin had entered into them, that's why it was hard in their lives. That's why God closed them. I did not want to talk about the wine. Noah had drunk wine. For him, the wine was a good thing. And you and me, sometimes we also see it as a good thing. I saw a brother drinking whiskey and he said, "This is for us, the apostle."
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 I've seen we went to a church campaign.
For us, it was not forbidden for us to drink the alcohol made by the
base. Now, for a Protestant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The
Baptists, they were drinking alcohol made out of maize. We came back from a campaign. And everywhere that we were going, they were giving us alcohol. And at the end, our pastor was drunk. And he was walking this way.
Amen.
Amen. And at the end, he fell into the bush. Drunk.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Masanga nyoso.
It will touch your brain.
Noah
made a
vino.
It was good for him.
Vino is a kitoko.
Even Proverbs says it.
Vino sans autre un verre is a kitoko.
Wine, if you're looking at it in a glass, it's beautiful.
Amen.
Amen. But when you drink it, it will bite you like a snake.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He drank the wine. But because of the wine, he found himself naked.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Many of us were in the church, we drink his wine. If I find you, I will not stop you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I don't stop anybody
anymore.
Many drink hiding. Many say they don't drink alcohol, but wine is okay. You start to defend yourself. Paul even said it.
Hallelujah.
Justify yourself.
Amen.
Paul has said it. Wine doesn't do anything. I've seen a servant of God say, Jesus even drank wine. That's why they were drinking wine. They were drinking wine. They were saying that beer is for poor people, but wine is what Jesus had drunk.
Amen.
Amen. When you are seeing it in the
wine,
but when you drink it, it's also beautiful as well. And you also it will go to your brain.
Amen.
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 Amen. When we first came to this country, before she arrived, me, Jodelle, and Francis, I used to cook all the time. I used to cook good food. I used to cook good food.
One day,
there were many people, and I said I will cook. And when we were cooking, and we put a little alcohol on the side, and we would drink a little bit.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And
everybody that was there, they knew that when I cook, it's great. But because I was drinking a little, it entered into my head.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because my head was not seeing what they were seeing.
Amen.
Amen. And those who but they were saying it's bad, but I was saying no, it's good.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Alcohol
is good when you're drinking
it.
But after drinking alcohol, many even
Donc,
assigned number one or two on the way. Amen.
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 I
know a servant of God.
He smoked some weed
in the sun. And he hid under the tree.
Oh, if you name him,
the things that hit the head and it makes
no
the head if Noah did not drink, he would not find himself naked.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But some people say, I drink and I control it. On that day, I cooked food that was burned.
Amen.
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 Amen. But what I want you to understand today, many of us are in the church, we are not understanding the things of God. The things of God, you do not argue about
it.
Receive it, believe it, and do it. And if you don't believe it, and if you don't understand it, bow down to God and ask God.
Don't argue. Ask God to give you the knowledge
for you to understand it.
Amen.
Amen. With our parents, there will always be problems. In the church, there will be problems. But your reaction after meeting the problem. Have you got that maturity to cover the
situation?
Have you got that maturity? They pray in that church, but they're gossiping about that church.
Amen.
Amen. Where you pray, but you're gossiping about it. You're gossiping about it, but on Sunday you go
there.
Some people, they insult their pastor, but on Sunday you will find them in the church.
Amen.
Amen. If you understand that they are servants of God, then you will not be able to insult them. In us, there are servants of God, those who are jokers. But know that they are of God.
So as a facade,
and if it's a joke, let God take control of him. It doesn't.
So as a facade, examples of charge.
If he's a joke, let God take control of him. But you, it's not your business. But don't let him manipulate you. Don't let him play with your spirit. Don't let him lie to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If they are doing
something that
the interest of God is in, obey it and do it.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God wants us to grow in the church. I say it all the time, church is
not about
people and then go. No. We come and we say to hear it, to understand it.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And for you to pray to God over the word that you have received. For it to grow inside you. For it to help you to grow in faith.
Amen.
Amen. That's why I say you have to have a Bible. A believer has to have a Bible. It's not for you to come and hear and not read your Bible. Read your Bible. If the pastor has forgotten, how would you know? I'm a man, I can forget.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And many people become, they're in the ministry of lies. Especially the prophets.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because qu'on lui prophétise.
The conversation that we had that we know about, I bring it to church and I make it into a prophecy. The children of God today, they will become, God has spoken to me. Especially the people of Lingala, that God speaks to them more than he spoke to Israel. God said, if you had a dream, say I had a dream. Don't say God had spoken to me. Many people, they don't have dreams anymore. They just say, I had a vision.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You have not understood what a vision is.
Amen.
Amen. Say, I had a dream.
Hallelujah.
Amen. A believer has to
grow.
We come to church so we can grow. So the words that we preach here
is
the key that will take us to heaven. Don't take it lightly. Don't neglect it. Because the word that Noah preached, but people laughed at him. People gossiped about him. God gave them all for them to see that Noah had heard him, but they refused to believe.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Especially the people that you know. He's from my end. How can he get a revelation? He's from my area. Who told you that God cannot speak to somebody from your area?
Amen.
Amen.
Then
he gives us a message here that when he went to go preach to somebody, and the man said, go, mom, cook for them because they're hungry. They said, Pastor, sit down. The mom is cooking for you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because they gossiped about Noah. They saw the proof. Animals are irrational. They don't think. But the animals heard the voice, they came, they did not ask the question. They entered into the ark. But people, it became a great
thing.
That uncle, he lives in the corner. They gave him a name.
Amen.
Amen. I'm sure they gave him a name. If he was in Congo, he would have 100 names all in one go. That man that shouts on the street. That man that built something. That man that is crazy, that is building some house.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God wants you to grow in the word. God wants you to grow in faith. God is looking for believers that are mature. You have the capacity to hear and to understand what is being said and to put it into practice. God wants you to have a testimony of the things that he has done for you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You are in the church for 2 years and you have no testimony.
Something is wrong.
Something is wrong.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are
in any church and you have been there for 2 years and you have no testimony of God, something is wrong. In 2 years, it's sufficient for you to say that I was like this, but I changed a little bit. God has changed me in something. I have not left it, but I am making the effort to move forward.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 The believers today, they don't want to hear. They want to see. They don't want to hear that there's
something.
All that they hear, they want to go and see. But it's the signs of the end time. They will say that if you came out from there, don't go. Because where you heard and you go, miracles will happen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But they are not of God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Believers today, they are following miracles. The Bible says, it's not you that follow miracles, but miracles will follow you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Miracles should follow you. But the believers today, because they're not mature, they are following miracles. One person is praying in four churches. You are lost if you're that way.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's normal.
It's normal for every believer to invite you somewhere and for you to go. But you will go back to your own church. A believer has to have their own church. You cannot have 3-4 churches.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Open
your ears. I'm not saying don't go to other churches. It's normal for you to be invited.
And I will support you when someone invites you and you go
to the church. But you have to have your own church where you go to. But the believers today, they pray to that church in the morning, in that church in the afternoon, and in that church in the evening. They are members of 3 churches in one go. Where you will receive your problem, you will not know.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Not every church has the same spirit. Not every church is led by the Spirit of God.
Even though
they have put it in big writing, the Church of Jesus Christ, it doesn't mean it's true. That's why I say, know where you are going. Know the testimony of the servant that is leading you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The believers today, because they are not mature, they are in London. They go to a church in London. They have a prophet in Congo. They have a prophet in Brazzaville. They have an apostle in Angola. They have a bishop in Canada.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You
have all these people. You don't know who's going to put a bad seed in your heart.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The person that you're calling on the phone. You are asking him for a subject of prayer. Do you know, you don't know his testimony?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Especially
during this time. As for people in Africa, our relationship is only through money.
Sorry to say
that,
but it's true.
Even with our families, our relationship is only through money.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I know a brother that died here, their family refused. They said, we don't want the body. He didn't help us with anything. And they said, don't cry for him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The relationship is only
for you.
And that apostle that you are calling up, he will take your money.
Hallelujah.
Amen. They will give you false prophecy. And at the end, you have to sow a seed.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You have to put a seed. Whatever problems you will have, because he knows you are in Europe.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Donc, on est très expérience pour la famille.
You've experienced something in the family.
Ma personne de mon amour moko révélation moi dans un doki.
They gave my family member the revelation that one of the child is.
Mon amour dans un akindoki.
That child is possessed.
Mais muda ubiki setata. Dans un afrikisi.
The only person that will save them is in South Africa.
Jiko yo osa le question faut foot ticket pour celle muda kolo la kindoki dans un afrikisi.
So you have to pay the ticket for that person that is in South Africa to come.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Famille potanande to inanande to kabwana.
The family was all arguing and we were separated.
Alléluia.
Amen.
Nous sommes pour bazana ndé bazana Afrique ici bana pour pas bénisser.
All that is because they had a family member
and
they wanted him to come. They needed somebody to buy a ticket for them.
Ale ba pesi prophecy mona naza misalama.
And they gave the prophecy your child is possessed.
Amen.
Amen.
Il faut qu'on kebra.
You have to be careful.
Mona naza fosa na makolo
e kele na mabele. You need to have your feet standing on the word. Your feet has to be on the word of God. Don't follow all that prophet, all that apostle, all that person.
Hallelujah.
Amen. You waste money.
Amen.
Amen. They will drive you around with useless conversation.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeba témoignage à oya zo kambayo.
Know the testimony of the person that is leading you.
Soki ba ba zaba prophet, awa zaba prophet. Poni, oluki prophet awa tebuke na lugwa bangana.
If they are prophets and hear their prophets, why do you have to go find a prophet in Congo?
E soki révélation ba pesa ba bino kutaka na Bible, awa pe ba Bible zali. Poni ni fola nda kuna.
If the revelation that they give to you comes from the Bible, the Bible says, why does it have to come from them?
Hallelujah.
Amen. It's not bad to have a connection with the servants of God. But know what you are looking from them. If you want to hear a lot, they will also say a lot to you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Be careful in the way
that you are.
God is everywhere. Your problem, if you look for God through you, God will work through you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I have no shame.
So na bondeli yo kana yo na bonde na bondeli.
If I pray for your issue. And I find that
it's
not giving me any solution. I have no
fear,
no shame
to call
another pastor to come and pray for you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. For me, it doesn't mean anything.
Na koko tinda yote.
I cannot send you. But if it's required for me to go with you, then we will go. Because I know everybody has their own
thing.
And if I don't have it, I will take you and we will go.
Tokenda na mama moko, tokenda po azali na problem, tokende kota la kizamina.
We went with a woman to go and visit, and she had a problem to go and see. We arrived there and I was,
and
they gave her a home and we went and they received us.
Lots
of women, they were all going one by one in the room. They will call you one by one in the room and you go. Kizamina will look at your issue and then you will leave. And when it was time for the woman that I went with her. And I told her. I said, this is not good. I said to him, this is not good.
And they gave
him a big house and they said you can have the house and all the, you can have your visitors. All the visitors are women. And then not long ago we saw a show in Kinshasa.
Prophet, I am
the prophet received a visitor. The guards were there. We have to grow in the things of God. To read the Bible is very important.
Alleluia.
Amen. I have no intention to lie to you. But I also can get lost.
Alleluia.
Amen. And maybe even I may not get lost. But nobody knows the things of God until the end. There's something that I know that you may know better than me.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. That's why when you are reading the Bible, we will all be a big group. We will be a stronger group. And God will help us together. But God wants you to grow. Not to grow in body, but to grow in spirit. To grow in the things of God. To fear God. To obey God. And it's something you do not understand. Call me. Come and meet me and we'll talk.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We have somebody here in the church. He went to another church and told me they have to baptize him. And he said to me, look where I went, this is what they said to me. I went to find out how he got his baptism. And I said to him, no, it's not necessary. You are already baptized.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Amen. People want to do many things. Yesterday I understood something. When somebody goes to a witch doctor, the witch doctor wants to give you a leaf to drink. He will give you a leaf to drink for you. But for him to give you the leaf, at the end for him just to give you that leaf.
Amen.
Amen. All that drama that he had done
is
for him to take your spirit. For at the end he will only give you a leaf. And that's the same thing that's happening in the church.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God has said for you to pray. All kinds of drama, all kinds of things.
Francesca, video na Facebook nanga.
I was showing Francesca a video on Facebook.
Amen.
An offering in Kinshasa. He came to give the offering. The things that we are copying in the church. You have to be careful. You have to be warned of all these emotions that they're making us go through. God told you to and which all of that is a form of to impersonate people. It's not godliness.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The things of Jesus, he did it simply. Even the preaching of Jesus was simple.
Amen.
Amen. The preaching of Jesus was simple. Somebody disturbed me and said, why do you preach in Lingala?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They
said, the assembly that I have, they understand Lingala better.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't let my mother, you tell her Lingala, it's a problem so good.
People think that you preach in Lingala, it makes you small.
Amen.
Amen.
Faut-il français.
You have to preach in French.
Amen.
Amen.
I said,
if I come to a church, a French church, I will preach in French. But in the assembly that I have, they understand Lingala better.
We
are using Lingala in English.
Amen.
Amen.
Et vous servez nani na yawa na bombarder nino na français minene ou bien ya boyo kite.
Wow, good would it be if I come here and I speak French?
Alors que nino a bousali yawa.
People will clap for me outside, but you here do not understand anything.
Nzamba ben nina na missionar me ma bino na destination.
God has called me in a mission to take you to a
destination.
And for me to take you to that destination,
il faut tous à la communication à bien.
We have to have a good communication between you and me. That's why I have no shame to say that if you do not understand my preaching, come and I will explain it to you.
Amen.
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 Be warned. Let us grow in coming to church. To obey the time is something that shows that we are growing. Let us obey the offering, it means that we are hearing, we are growing. It's something that we do in the church, you do not understand, come, let's talk about it.
Question time.
Don't wait for the question time ministry.
Amen.
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 Amen. Hallelujah.